Something weird is going on in the streets of the United States. Over the years, vehicles have gotten much safer for the driver. But if you're not in the vehicle, the roads are way more dangerous than they were just a decade ago, to the point that pedestrians now make up 17% of traffic fatalities. The weird thing is, this problem seems to be much worse in America. The number of pedestrian deaths here each year is twice as high as it is in an area of Europe with more people. If you think you know why, you might want to hit the brakes, because there are several reasons US streets have become so deadly for walkers. And nobody's talking about some of them, except highway safety researchers and us. Car crashes involving pedestrians are way more common than we'd like them to be, and in the US, they're becoming more common every year. From 2010 to 2022, pedestrian deaths from vehicle impacts here increased by 77% to more than 7,000 annually. The pooled data from 27 European countries shows less than half that many pedestrian fatalities, despite having more than 100 million more people. These figures vary state to state or country to country, but the overall trends are hard to ignore. America has a problem, partly because we're driving bigger vehicles. Places like the US, China, and the EU have incentivized manufacturers to make larger vehicles over the last few decades with less stringent fuel efficiency requirements on them than smaller cars. Essentially, when it comes to regulations, the bigger the vehicle, the less fuel efficient it needs to be, and the more emissions are allowed. And if you're in the US, that requirement is lowered another notch for four-wheel light trucks. So we're making more big vehicles, but we're also partial to larger vehicles. Over the last decade, vehicles like crossovers and pickups have gotten more popular, while passenger cars are being left in the dust. And that's bad news for pedestrians, according to a study by the Insurance Institute for Highway Safety. The researchers there found that the largest vehicles, which had a hood height of over a meter from the ground, increased the risk of pedestrian mortality by at least 44%. This is largely because the way those vehicles hit pedestrians leads to more severe head injuries. So taller vehicles mean worse head injuries, which in turn increases pedestrian mortality risk. But that doesn't tell us if taller vehicles hit pedestrians more often than smaller vehicles, because they might not. But before I can explain why, we need to run an ad.
Thanks to Jump for supporting this SciShow video. Jump is a statistical analysis software that makes powerful analytics quick and accessible. With Jump, you can customize software to suit your needs without doing any coding of your own. The new Jump Marketplace lets you download pre-made applications, add-ins, data connectors, and other Jump extensions for free. That lets you generate almost any type of process control chart, from X-bar charts to P-charts. Then, to sort through all of those choices, Jump's model screening platform helps you find the best model for your data by comparing them back to back. And last, you can use their measurement systems analysis platform to steer clear of measurement bias. They offer all of that with a 30-day free trial for anyone, anywhere at jmp.com/scishow.
In 2002, cars were responsible for more pedestrian fatalities than light trucks. But that might have been because the streets were still crawling with Toyota Camrys and Honda Accords. If you take into account the total distance traveled by the two categories, larger vehicles were worse. And by 2022, the risk from light trucks grew so much that however you looked at the numbers, they were worse. The biggest culprit of all, though, might be SUVs. The number of pedestrian fatalities caused by those vehicles rose by 82%, from 2009 to 2016. Taken together, this means larger vehicles are increasingly more involved in collisions with pedestrians and more deadly when those collisions happen. But vehicle size is not the only explanation. The shape of the hood can also play a role. Cars like the 2012 Honda Odyssey with sloped hoods pose lower risk, similar to smaller sedans like the 2004 Toyota Camry. Vehicles like the 2010 Chevy Colorado with a sharper angle at the front and a flatter hood on top pose a 26% higher risk of pedestrian death. Even the angle of the hood seems to make a difference. The Colorado has a lower grade than the Odyssey, and that's associated with a 25% increase in risk. These cars are not small, but they're smaller than the largest SUVs. And once you start talking about those, fatality risk doesn't really change based on hood shape. Above a meter hood height, it's just more deadly regardless of hood shape. The sheer size factor is dangerous for a few reasons, like the cabs of those vehicles can literally block the road from your line of sight. A study from 2022 put trucks to the test, either putting drivers in a simulated low visibility truck cab or a higher visibility truck cab. In the high visibility cab, none of the drivers hit any pedestrians during the simulation. In 39 out of the 45 low visibility tests, the drivers did hit the pedestrian. Note to self, avoid crossing in front of big trucks. A study from 2022 found that often SUVs and pickups were more likely to hit pedestrians than cars, and the researchers suspected that has to do with visibility. Specifically, the design of something called the A-pillar, or the part at the front of the car that wraps around the windshield. Some vehicles have thicker beams at the end of your windshield, which can obscure pedestrians. Small vehicles can have problems with visibility too, so I'm not picking on pickups. I'm looking at you, Prius. But the gist is, worse visibility means more pedestrian collisions. So there are a lot of ways that vehicle design can be geared toward pedestrian safety, but there are factors beyond the car itself that influence pedestrian safety, like driver behavior. Pedestrians fare better if drivers are actually looking out for them. Between 2005 and 2010, distracted drivers killed almost 2,500 pedestrians in the US. And again, while this isn't only a US problem, the data signals that Americans are particularly distracted drivers. According to the CDC, in 2011, almost 70% of US adults had talked on their cell phone while driving in the last 30 days at least once, compared to around 60% in Portugal, around 50% in the Netherlands, and a mere 20% in the UK. In fact, over 70% of UK respondents reported never using their cell phone while driving in the last 30 days, pretty much the opposite of US respondents. A more recent study by Cambridge Mobile Telematics looked at more than 2 years of driving and cell data and found that US drivers spend 3 times as much time on their cell phones while driving compared to UK drivers, which translates to way more fatalities for drivers and pedestrians alike. Now, I'm sure you've been lectured about distracted driving before, but distracted walking is also a problem. As a pedestrian, you can decrease your own risk of collision by making sure you're not distracted by things like pets, conversations, and phones. I really need to stop playing Pokemon Go while crossing the street. It's also safer if you stay on the sidewalk, but that isn't always possible since 59% of pedestrian deaths in 2017 occurred on streets where there was just straight up no sidewalk. And that statistic has been going up, reaching a peak of 68% in 2021. No sidewalks means there's nothing between a pedestrian and 1,000 kilograms of metal hurtling down the street. So in addition to the vehicles and the people interacting with them, the roads themselves can also affect fatality rates. In 2021 and 2022, almost 60% of pedestrian fatalities happened on arterial roads, which are those higher speed streets that aren't quite freeways. No big surprise here, but faster travel on roadways is more dangerous for pedestrians. The risk of death is 10% at 23 miles per hour, 50% at 42 miles per hour, and 90% at 58 miles per hour. But there are ways to slow down the flow of traffic and make it safer for pedestrians. Roads can be designed with sidewalks, narrower lanes, or rougher pavement. Maybe the potholes are a good thing? One study even suggests steering clear of paved roads entirely in places and replacing them with bricks or granite blocks to slow vehicles down and improve pedestrian safety. And again, other countries appear to be better at using these traffic interventions than the US. Toward the end of 2023, Wales changed the default speed limit on many of their roads from 48 kilometers per hour to 32 kilometers per hour. In the first quarter of 2024, they saw more than 100 fewer collisions and fatalities compared to the first quarter of 2023. And that trend held for subsequent quarters too. Some communities in the United Kingdom also imposed the 32 kilometers per hour speed limit, with one borough seeing a 40% drop in pedestrian fatalities afterwards. In Spain, raised crosswalks reduce driver speeds by up to 10 kilometers per hour, and it keeps them at that pace if they're in an urban neighborhood. Speed cameras also show promise, with drivers generally staying below the speed limit while they're in the speed monitored zone. It would be great to implement these changes in all US best neighborhoods, but in lieu of that, it would be helpful to at least focus on places that have the highest rates of pedestrian deaths. Right now, low-income neighborhoods and people of color are disproportionately affected by pedestrian collisions and fatalities. A study in the American Journal of Public Health examined how pedestrian fatalities varied across neighborhoods affected by racist redlining practices. The worst-ranked neighborhoods were disproportionately Black and immigrant and saw 2.6 times as many pedestrian fatalities as predominantly white neighborhoods. This aligns with another study which showed that Black pedestrians are killed at 2.2 times the rate of white pedestrians. Even emergency department visits for pedestrian injuries are about 2 times higher among Black and other non-white races. Adding raised sidewalks in these neighborhoods could help keep vulnerable people walking to school and work safer. So the US has a long way to go to lower its pedestrian fatality rate. It comes down to the choices of individuals to drive cars with lower and sloped hoods, drive them slower, and stay focused behind the wheel, and the infrastructure investments to protect people in the highest risk areas. But if we make some very reasonable changes, we could turn a corner for pedestrian safety.